Welcome, my dear students. Today we are going to solve all the question answers from the poem Count Your Garden. The following things are mentioned in the poem. Classify them as happy and sad things. First is flowers, falling leaves, golden hours, clouds, stars, shadows, smile, tears, friends in your life, passing years. Okay, next is happy things and sad things. In happy things, we all can see is flowers, golden hours, stars, smiles, friends in your life. And in sad things, we can see falling leaves, clouds, shadows, tears, passing years. Okay, next is name few other things that people often count. Okay, people often count the amount of money they have, the problems they are facing, their position in their workplaces, and the electronic goods they possess, etc. Okay, so these are the few things. Next is write down the good things that are there in your life. That is good parents, good school, good house. That's it. If you want, you can add in it a little more. Next, we can see that pick out two pairs of rhyming words from the poem. They are flowers, hours, fall, all, tears, and ears. Okay? Next is the opposite words. Here it is never, always, day, night, remember, forget, smile, frown, joy, misery. Next we can see is the extra question which we can put in it is read the poem and answer the question given below. What is the central idea of the poem? The central idea of the poem is that we should learn to look at the brighter side of the life and always count our blessings. Next is, according to the poet, how should we count our garden? So, according to the poet, we should count our garden by the flowers in it. Next is, what should we not remember at all? We should not remember the dark clouds at all. What should we do joyfully on every birthday? On every birthday, we should joyfully count our age by friends and not by the years that pass. Explain the line, count your life by smiles. The above line means that there will be happy times and sad times in our lives. We should count our blessings by the happy times and not those which moved us to tears. Okay, next. See here, pick out the rhyming word is already given, so no need to write, but still it's flowers, hours, tall, all, tears, ears. Give another title to the poem, that is count your blessing. How do you react when you are disappointed? When I am disappointed, I think of the times when things were good. I speak to my parents and share my problems with them. I try to smile and face the situation bravely. Okay, this is a group work. Discuss how you will measure the worth of a book, a sport event, a friend, and a journey. Let's start first with a book. A book, I will measure the worth of a book by the number of interesting things that are given in it and the amount of knowledge I get from it. I will not like it if there are too many difficult words, for then I will have to keep consulting a dictionary and the joy of reading will become less. If it is a story book, the story or plot is also important, and finally the price of the book and the illustrations are important. Okay? Next is a sports event. A sport event provides us different varied experiences. It sometimes brings forth our competitive spirit. We witness joy in victory and sorrow in loss. We learn to be humble in victory and take defeat with a smile. We learn to give our best. The worth of a sports event can be measured by the enjoyment it provides and the lesson it imparts. Okay, next is a friend. A friend is a gift from God. Someone who is by our side through happy and sad times. Through our smile and tears, a friend's worth can be measured. When he or she display the value of love and care and never leaves our side when we are in distress and help us in very way he or she can be. Okay. Next is a journey. A journey can teach us so much of things as we travel. We see various sights and scenes which encourage us to think, learn and understand. A journey is worth the effort if it is interesting, educative and enriching. Next is, write the answer to the following question. How should you count the richness of your garden? You should count the richness of your garden by the number of flowers that it has. Next, how should you count your age? Obviously, you should count your age by the numbers of friends you have. Next is, what does the poet actually want to tell us? The poet wants to tell us that we must count the good things that we have in our lives and not the problems. We must look at the positive side of life and not the negative one. Okay children, here we end with it. If you really found my video informative, please do like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you children for watching my videos.